All right, B. Who are you and what's your game? Well, if it isn't my dear old chum, Mr. Disraeli. Now, Prime Minister, which of your friends is about to stab you in the back?
The Corrupt Practices Bill is a vital step in reforming our government.
An exception.
If the majority party is allowed to dictate results of contested elections, we can scarcely call ourselves free.
If we yield up our rights bit by bit to the courts, we can scarcely call ourselves free, sir.
This is so like you, Gladstone. You would rather throw your body upon the gears of progress than surrender one iota of power.
By God, Disraeli, you are a fool! I'll not stand idly by and watch you drag parliamentary privilege through the muck.
No, certainly not. You'd rather return us to the yoke of tyranny. Perhaps while we're at it, Mr. Gladstone, we could repeal Magna Carta and return the crown to the bloody Stuarts.
How dare you, sir? I'm certain it would provide. Merely because I do not wish to see government placed in the hands of judges, you would make these slanderous accusations? I'll not stand for it.
Then I shall obviate the requirement. Good evening, sir.
B, I presume.
Mother of God!
You'll have to come down sometime!
Pleasure to meet you. B?
B! My name's Herbert!
Then why are you following the Prime Minister?
It's just the job, sir! Some old bloke paid me to...
Smug bastard. Well, I was born in Crawley, but that's by the by. Who are you working for?
I never got his name. Old chap, big moustache, wore some kind of uniform. Who's ours, maybe?
What's his game?
Please, you'll kill me.
And a three-story drop will shatter your legs and send you to the workhouse. Difference is, you can run from him.
Tomorrow! My lads are going to attack the Prime Minister's carriage on the way to Parliament.
Perfect. So much for the house call. I have to find a way into that carriage.
Better keep an eye on him.
What's the meaning of this? Who the devil are you?
Prime Minister, I'm your new bodyguard, Jacob Fry.
I wasn't informed of any new bodyguard. Who's your commanding officer?
Let the boy speak, Dizzy.
Madam, apologies. But we've learned of a threat on your life. And the Met thought it best to move quickly.
Threat? What sort of threat?
That sort. If you excuse me a moment.
Where'd they come from?
What's all this?
Not so fast, Your Excellency.
Hey! Get back here with that Prime Minister!
Walk on, girl.
Yeah!
Easy!
Everyone all right?
We seem to have come through unscathed. You have our thanks, Mr. Fry.
It was Gladstone. I bet my life on it. This is perfectly in keeping with this distinct lack of character.
Show yourself, Gladstone! Show yourself, you feckless mutt-snipe!
Easy, does it.
Well, he's hardly going to be in the band. Sure, does he?
Yeah. That's a good...
Gladstone, that bloody man! He will pay for this!
Thank you. What do you intend to do about Gladstone, young man?
I assure you, madam, Gladstone is innocent in this.
But he tried to kill my husband.
Well, we'll look into Gladstone. Perhaps you can help me with another inquiry, madam. A gentleman with ties to Parliament, older, wears cavalry uniforms and has a large mustache.
You seem like a rough-and-ready sort of fellow, Mr. Fry.
Well, yes, I am, actually.
And are you familiar with the poorer districts of our city?
Roughly.
Wonderful. As it happens, I've been eager to tour the Devil's Acre. If you were to escort me, I'd be happy to assist you in your inquiry.
That strikes me as a dangerous idea.
Then it's settled. Come back here to Downing Street tomorrow night, 8 o'clock sharp. Good day, Mr. Fry.
But I...
Good day, Mr. Fry!
Madam?
Mr. Fry.
Ready to take the air? Devil's Acre should just be coming alive.
I'm afraid I must cancel our engagement. The lawn is crawling with scandal-hunting journalists, and I simply cannot be seen in the company of someone so...
I'll see them off. You follow along when it's clear.
Yes, yes. Be gentle, won't you? The press are notoriously touchy about any violence to their person.
Ha ha ha. I'll barely ruffle a hair on their heads.
Shh, Desmond.
My mother won't be in for hours.
There's been a murder! Help! A cold-blooded murder!
That's yours, murder! If you can get those chaps over there to follow me.
Right, you
are, sir. I can't believe your peepers!
It's murder!
Blimey! Look! Esquire Bancroft!
It's been a murder!
Best lead them astray before they tear me to shreds.
Young man. Dizzy ought to keep you on to deal with the liberals. Now, a drive is...
Steady on.
There, in the cart, is the Prime Minister's wife.
I really must not be seen here, Mr. Fry.
Doing fine, girl.
What a rough place. Give me your arm, Mr. Fry. Let us see what the Devil's Acre has to offer.
Is your dog quite all right?
Oh, Desmond's fine. He's just not overfond of strangers. Or cats. Do you know this gentleman is a... Oh, what was it? Yes, a costermonger, of all things. Remarkable how the working classes occupy themselves, isn't it?
Very industrious, I'm sure. Shall we go?
Only cutthroats hide like that.
I've done a bit of hiding myself.
Oh, shut up, over here.
Come on, we ain't got all day.
Yeah, it won't be a moment. Excuse me, but
this is just... And so the vicar says, your pardon, Bishop. I thought that was the Eucharist.
I'm so sorry. I have no earthly idea what you're talking about.
Mrs. Disraeli.
Well, clearly someone must put an end to this rumpus.
God!
No offense, my dear, but I believe there is a reason. Is there any politics?
Mr. Fly, look at those two.
Yes, they seem to be,
I've been married twice, Mr. Fly. I'm fully aware of what they're doing. God bless them.
I beg of you, let me live.
What sort of meat is that man selling?
Best not to ask.
Why? Is it something dreadful? Is it rat?
I don't mean to be indelicate, given the present company, but another name for it is bow wow mutton. Here we are. The old what?
So, this is a pint, is it? Remarkable.
Nice doggy.
Good boy, Desmond. Hand over the mutt.
You'll change your tune when me and my friends find you.
Now then, Desmond, to get you back to your mistress, whom I've just left entirely unattended in one of London's most dangerous pubs.
Well, if you never told your father how you felt about him, how was he supposed to know?
I never thought of it that way. I suppose deep down we all just want to be loved.
Just so. Here, have a sweetie. Oh, Desmond and Mr. Fry, I'd like you to meet... Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
John the Tosser.
Charmed. I think we better get you home.
Right you are, Mr. Fry. Come along, Desmond.
Well, well, well. If it isn't the dog walker.
Now, let's not do something we'll regret. Let's go. That's the way. Who's a good horse? You are.
Whoa! Well, I must thank you for a most energetic and enlightening evening, Mr. Fry.
No, thank you, madam. Perhaps now you might tell me about the man in the hussar's uniform.
Quite right. Lord Cardigan.
Steady on.
Is the gentleman you seek. Tiresome man. Always blathering on about his military adventures.
Do you know where I might find him for a private conversation?
I do indeed. He's in town now, as it happens. Campaigning against the Corrupt Practices Bill. Perhaps you could catch him in the Palace of Westminster. Oh, do be careful. The government could ill afford another scandal.
I assure you, I'll be very discreet. Keep moving.
Whoa, then!
Your stop, madam.
My stop? How delightful. Thank you. Thank you for a splendid evening, Mr. Fry. I shall be sure to speak highly of you to Dizzy. Oh, yes.